Today on Contraption, we're going to see some classic moments from Walt Disney's best-loved films. You at home can play along as we ask our studio team's questions about these films. Our categories are books, animals, heroes and villains, and magic. And to run the proceedings, here's our Commissioner of Contraption, Ralph Harris.
Well, thank you. Thank you. And thank you, Miranda. Hi, everybody. We're ready to play. We've got some great prizes, some terrific kids. And here come our Contraption coaches, Kevin and Robin, with today's team. Now, our teams were randomly selected before the show. And Robin is the coach of the Red Racer, so let's meet the team.
Hi, my name is Teddy Boo, and I like trains, and I have 17 trains at my house.
Hi, my name is Melissa, and I'm interested in writing, and I collect fingerprints and stamps.
Okay. My name is Cicely Tanner, and I collect unicorns.
Sounds like a pretty good team, and Kevin is going to be the coach of the Blue Rockers, so let's meet them.
My name is Eric Wilson, and I collect stickers.
My name is Stacy Marie, and I can ice skate. And when I get some children, I'm going to teach them how.
Hi, my name is Michael Suss, and I might want to be a potter when I grow up, and I like to read.
Well, I'd say we've got two great teams here, and kids, we're glad you're with us today. Good luck to everybody. Now, we have deposited three passports in each team's bank, and inside each passport is the name of the first station our kids will be going to today. So, kids, go to the dugout, pick up your passports, and let's play Contraption! Okay! Our first station is books. So, who's got a passport that says books? Come on over! Well, it looks like Stacy for the blue team, Teddy for the red team. Stacy, you were talking about ice skating, and you're going to teach your kids. How much do you skate?
Not very often.
Well, do you skate indoor or outdoor?
Outdoor. I mean indoor.
Yeah, that's right, because you got to skate where there's ice, right?
Mm-hmm.
And have you ever hurt yourself, or have you ever done anything where you said, boy, I'm not going to do that again?
Yes.
What'd you do?
I slid across the ice, and I
got all wet and cold. I've done that myself. Okay, we're going to play in a minute. Good luck. First, let's go over and say hello to Teddy. Teddy, you were talking about trains. How many you got?
17.
17 different trains?
Yes.
Is that cars or engines?
It's engines and cars.
And they all go at the same time?
Well, sometimes I make it go at the same times. At the same time.
Wow, that's a lot of trains. You ready to play?
Yes.
Okay, well, good luck to everybody. Now, we're all going to be looking at a scene from a classic Walt Disney movie. At the end of the scene, I'm going to be asking you kids questions about it, and every time you give me a right answer, you're going to earn one very valuable contraptile. At the end of the show, the team with the most contraptiles is going to win a bundle of prizes. And I'm also going to have a special question just for you at home, so maybe you want to get a pencil and paper and write down the answer. Although the book Robin Hood is mostly about action and adventure, it's also a love story. In this scene from the classic Disney film, Robin gets some friendly advice about romance from his merry men. So kids, turn around, and everybody, watch the screen.
Look, why don't you stop mooning and moping around? Just marry the girl.
Marry her? You don't just walk up to a girl, hand her a bouquet, and say, hey, remember me? We were kids together. Will you marry me?
No, it just isn't done that way.
Oh, come on, Robbie. Climb the castle walls. Sweep her off her feet. Carry her off in style.
It's no use, Johnny. I've thought it all out. It just wouldn't work. Besides, what have I got to offer her?
Well, for one thing, you can't cook.
I'm serious, Johnny. She's a highborn lady of quality.
So she's got class. So what?
I'm an outlaw, that's what. That's no life for a lovely lady always on the run. What kind of a future is that?
Oh, for heaven's sake, son. You're no outlaw. Why, someday you'll be called a great hero.
A hero? Did you hear that, Johnny? We've just been pardoned.
Oh, that's a gas. We ain't even been arrested yet.
All right, laugh, you two rogues. but there's going to be a big to-do in Nottingham. Well, that ain't it. Old Prince John's having a championship archery tournament tomorrow.
Archery tournament? Old Rob could win that standing on his head, huh, Rob?
Thank you, Little John. But I'm sure we're not invited.
No, but there's somebody who'll be very disappointed if you don't come.
Yeah, old Bushel Britches, the Honorable Sheriff of Nottingham.
No, Maid Marian.
Maid Marian?
Yeah, she's going to give a kiss to the winner.
Kiss to the winner? Ooh, da lally.
Come on, Johnny, what are we waiting for?
Wait a minute, Rob, hold it. That place will be crawling with soldiers.
Aha, but remember, faint hearts never won fair lady. Fear not, my friends. This will be my greatest...
Okay, a wonderful seat. Big turnaround, here we go. Now, every time you give me a right answer, you're going to hear this sound. And you're going to earn one very valuable contraptile. And remember, at the end of the show, the team with the most contraptiles, grand prize winner. So good luck, and here we go, starting with the blue team, Stacy. Robin Hood could not stop thinking about Maid Marian. What did Little John, the bear, suggest he do? Take a guess. Marry her. He said Robin should marry her. Over to Teddy and the red team. Robin Hood said Maid Marian was a high-born lady of quality. What did he say he was? Take a guess. An outlaw. He said he was an outlaw. Tough questions here. Back to the blue team. Stacy. What was the big event being held in Nottingham? Take a guess. It was an archery tournament with bows and arrows. Okay, over to the red team. Teddy. The winner of the tournament would receive a special prize. What was it?
Marion the maid would kiss the winner.
A kiss, correct. One contraptile for the red team. Okay, guys, the ice is broken. That ends the questions for this round, and you both got your teams off to a start. Now you're going to have a chance to add to your winnings in our exciting jungle boat race. So, kids, if you'll get in the jungle boat, coaches, if you'll help them, and while they're getting ready, here's that special home question we promised just for you. In the scene, when Robin Hood shot his arrow, it hit something that was hanging on a tree. What did his arrow hit? Later on in the show, we'll tell you the answer so you can see how well you did, but right now, let's get to that jungle boat race. Kids, one contraptile to the runner-up, two to the winner, and take off when you hear the whistle. On your mark. Get set. Race. Teddy was a close runner-up. Come on over here, kids. Good going, Stace. Good going, Teddy. Gonna come on around here. Runner-up, not bad in a very close race. Stacy wins it. Miranda, how many contraptiles has each team won?
Well, Teddy won two contraptiles for the Red Racers, and Stacy won two contraptiles for the Blue Rockers.
Well, good going, good start, kids. Now go to the dugout, put those contraptiles in your team banks. Wow, good job. Well done. Station is animals, so let's have our kids whose passport said animals come on over. Looks like Mike for the blue team and Sicily for the red team. Hi, Sicily. Hello.
Hello.
I've been told that you collect unicorns. Want to tell us about unicorns?
Well, the thing I like about them is the horns.
They all have one horn right in the middle of their forehead. What's that for? I don't know either, but it looks nice, doesn't it?
Yes.
Okay, we're going to play in a minute, so be ready. Now we're going to say hello to Mike. Mike, you're interested in pottery. You said you were going to throw pots. How do you do that?
Well, you put it down on a thing that when you plug it, it spins, and you get it wet, and then when you can stick your hand down there and get it, for it makes a hole, and then you can put your fingers or some metal things for it to make.
And you end up with a pot. All that work, and you end up with a pot. All right, well, good luck. You ready to play? All right, kids, here we go. When Mowgli gets captured by the monkeys, a bear named Baloo and a panther named Bagheera come up with a daring plan to rescue him. So kids, turn around, and everybody, watch closely.
Lay the secret on me of man's red fire.
But I don't know how to make fire.
Now don't try to kid me, man cub. I made a deal with you. What I desire is man's red fire to make my dream come true. Now give me the secret, man cub. Come on, clue me what to do. Give me the power of man's red flower so I can be like you.
Fire. So that's what that scoundrel's after. I'll tear him limb from limb. I'll beat him out. Yeah. Well, man, what a beat. Will you stop that silly beat business and listen? This will take brains, not brawn. You better believe it, and I'm loaded with both. Will you listen? Oh, yeah. Now, while you create a disturbance, I'll rescue Mowgli. Got that?
I'm gone, man. Solid gone.
Not yet, Baloo!
Up and running, up the baby ladder, up and rolling, and the baby that do sabba do the day, do bump the boot the day, the bones of up and bobby.
Abba do dee,
will a reap a naza,
ever do a doy,
will a la bazini,
will a but, will a but,
steeple a doody, will a ha 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 ha. Get mad, baby.
I wanna be like you.
I wanna walk like you. Talk like you. Do woo woo. You see it's you. Someone like me.
Can learn to be like someone like me.
Take me home, daddy. Can learn to be like someone like you.
One more time.
Yeah, can learn to be like someone like me. Say da ba 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 da doodle da 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 da.
All right, what a fun scene. Turn around, kids, and here we go. Remember, one contraptile for every correct answer. And remember, you at home can play along with us right here. See if you can answer the question along with our contraption kids. This time, we're going to start with the blue team and Mike. What secret did the monkeys want to learn from Mowgli? Take a guess. They wanted to know how to make fire. Over to the red team in Sicily. Bagheera, the panther, said it would take more than brawn to rescue Mowgli. What else did he say it would take? Take a guess. He said it would take brains. Brains as well as brawn. Okay, Mike, blue team. To hide himself from the monkeys, Bagheera pretended to be something. What did he pretend he was?
Like a dancer with the other guys. With the, like, he was dancing with the other guys. He dressed up for he'd be like them, for they wouldn't notice him.
But it was a statue. It was a statue that he pretended to be. Okay, we're going to go back to Sicily. What animal disguised himself as a monkey?
Blue.
Baloo the bear is absolutely correct. One contraptile for the red team in a very tough round. Okay, kids, now we're going to have a chance to win some more contraptiles in the Wheels of Fire race. So, Mike, go ahead over there. Sicily, go ahead. Coaches, if you'll help into the Wheels of Fire. One contraptile to the runner-up, two to the winner, and take off when you hear the whistle. Coaches, are we ready? On your marks. Get set.
Here we go.
battle that was, almost a come from behind. Sicily wins it for the red team, but Mike almost came up with a come from behind victory. Come on over. Good going, both of you. Close race. And Miranda, how many contraptiles do we owe these people?
Well, Sicily won 3 contraptiles for the Red Racers, and Mike won 1 contraptile for the Blue Rockers.
Okay, kids, good going. Now head to the dugout, put those contraptiles in your team banks. Good job. Well played. While the kids are going over that way, I'm going this way to our next station, which just happens to be Heroes and Villains. And I think I've got some people coming up to meet me. It looks like Eric for the blue team, Melissa for the red team, and right in the right spot. Hi, Eric.
Hi.
You're going to be a football player. You like to tackle people?
Yeah, it's fun.
Is it? What's fun about it? The running and the exercise or what? Well, it's a nice sport. I mean, it's competitive, and you get to play a lot, right?
Yeah, it's tough.
It's tough. Okay, well, this is a tough game, too, and we're going to be getting there in just a minute, but right now let's say hi to Melissa. You collect things? What kind of things do you collect?
Well, I collect fingerprints and stamps.
Wait a minute. Fingerprints? How do you collect fingerprints?
Well, like, I have this Charlie Brown book, and it explains it. You take this card, and you can make it into a chart. You make these squares. You put, like, right thumb, right index, you know, and all the fingers, and then you put left in the same things.
Just like the FBI.
And then you put it.
It's done, and you have it.
In the box under the writing, you take something and you
press it down, and you got an ink print. Okay, well, that sounds interesting, and right now we're going to play a game that's interesting, and that's Contraption, of course. Now, kids, Peter Pan proves to be a brave and resourceful hero as he fights his old enemy, the villainous Captain Hook. But as you'll see, the captain isn't the only villain around. So kids, turn around, and everybody, eyes on the screen.
Peter!
Here's your spirit, Smee!
Why, it's Peter Pan.
Scurvy brat!
Thank you, Captain.
Come down, boy, if you've a taste for cold steel.
Watch this, Wendy.
Oh, Peter, do be careful.
Try your luck, Mr. Smee.
Let him have it. Come on, you idiot. Blast him.
Right here, Mr. Smee.
Hold it, you fool. No, no.
Captain?
Oh, how dreadful.
What a pity, Mr. Smee. I'm afraid we've lost the dear captain.
Captain!
In the back, Captain?
Give it to him, Captain! Cleave him to the brisket!
I got you this time, Pan.
Well, well, a codfish on a hook.
I'll get you for this, Pan, if it's the last thing I do.
I say, Captain, do you hear something?
No. No! No!
Well, Mr. Crocodile, do you like codfish?
You do?
Oh, Peter, no!
An exciting scene. Okay, kids, I see you're turned around already. Now, at this point, I checked on the contraptor counters, and the red team is a little bit ahead, but that could change right now. We're going to start with the blue team. Eric, what did the evil pirate, Captain Hook, use to grab Peter's hat?
His hook.
His hook is correct. Contraptile for the blue team. Melissa, red team, What was Captain Hook holding that Peter bounced on with one foot?
The sword?
The sword is correct, Contraptile for the red team. Back to the blue and Eric. What object did Peter pull down over Mr. Smee's face?
A gun.
Oh, it wasn't a gun. He pulled his cap down over his face, his hat. Back to the red team. Melissa, what kind of weapon did Mr. Smee use to try and stop Peter Pan?
A gun.
That was a gun. Contraptile for the red team. Okay, kids, that means that's the end of the questions for this round, and then it's race time again, so get into those magic carpets that we're going to be racing this time. Coaches, if you'll help them. And while they're getting ready, here's the answer to that special home question that we asked you earlier. The question was, when Robin Hood shot his arrow, it hit something that was hanging on a tree. What did his arrow hit? The answer is a frying pan. We hope you got it right. But right now, let's get to the magic carpet race. Kids, take off when you hear the whistle. On your mark, get set. Melissa won it by a hair. Come on over. Congratulations. Good race, Eric. Runner-up. Good race. It was so close. Miranda, how many contraptiles has each team won?
Well, Ralph, Melissa won 3 contraptiles for the Red Racers, and Eric won 2 contraptiles for the Blue Walkers.
Well, good going, kids. Now head to the dugout, bank those contraptiles, and it was a great round. Very well played. And while the kids are going to the dugout, I'm going over this way and get ready for the bonus round. And in the bonus round, every correct answer is worth 5 contraptiles, so this is still anybody's game. The red team is a little bit ahead, but that could change right now. This is the magic station, and we need all the kids from both teams, and here they are, Eric, Stacy, and Mike for the blue team, Teddy, Melissa, and Cicely for the red team, and this is going to decide it, kids. The unique magic of Mary Poppins leaves Jane and Michael wide-eyed with amazement, and it did the same for audiences everywhere. With scenes like this one. So kids, turn around and everybody watch closely.
Well, first things first. I always say the place to hang a hat is on a hat stand. I much prefer seeing all of my face at the same time.
But there was nothing in it.
Never judge things by their appearance. Even carpet bags. I'm sure I never do. A thing of beauty is a joy forever.
A little more light, perhaps.
We better keep an eye on this one.
She's tricky.
She's wonderful.
Much better. Now, let me see. I always carry it with me. It must be here somewhere.
What?
My tape measure.
What do you want it for?
I want to see how you two measure up. Oh, that's the funniest thing I ever saw. And that's the funniest thing.
There it is.
Good. Come along, then. Quickly. Head up, Michael. Don't slouch. Just as I thought. Extremely stubborn and suspicious.
I am not.
See for yourself.
Extremely stubborn and suspicious.
All right. A wonderful scene. Okay, kids, turn around Here we go. This could decide it. Remember, in the bonus round, I'll ask a question. You get to talk it over with your teammates, and then I'll ask one of you for the answer that the team decided on. So starting with the blue team. Blues. Mary Poppins carried an unusual carpet bag with many things in it. When she needed to hang up her hat, what did she take out of the bag?
A hat.
Talk it over. Talk it over.
A hat
hanger. Mike?
A hanger. A hat hanger. We hang your hat on it. Hat hanger.
A hat hanger is correct. It's a hat rack, a coot rack, five contrap piles for the blue team. Red team. What did she take out so that she could see all of her face? Talk it over. Okay, Sicily.
The mirror.
Mirror is correct. Five contrap piles for the red team. Blue team. What did the children say was in the bag when they looked inside? Walk it over. Stacy.
Nothing.
Nothing is correct. Five more contrap piles for the blue team. And finally, the red team. What did Mary say was a thing of beauty when she took it out of the bag? Melissa.
Plants.
Plant is correct. Five contrap piles for the red team and kids. That ends the bonus round. It ends the game. And now the moment we've all been waiting for. Let's go to those contrapta counters. Pile on those contrap tiles. And let's find out who today's winner is. And there are, boy, those banks. Those banks are emptying out fast. The red team up to 7, 8, 9. Blue team is already at 10. They're still coming, 11, 12. Red is up to 15, 16. Blue is at 15. Blue team has 15. The red team has 18. Red team wins it. Congratulations. And Miranda, what have we got in today's prize package?
For lunchtime or any time, a Magic Kingdom lunch pot with unbreakable thermos. The beautifully illustrated keepsake treasury of children's classics. A delightful long-playing record album with its own read-along book. Memories of great movies with the great read-aloud classics books of film favorites. And two tickets to Disneyland for a full day of adventure and enchantment. Today, each lucky member of our winning team will receive a special grand prize. Their very own Texas Instruments home computer for years of fascinating fun and learning. All for you from Contraption.
Well, congratulations to everybody. It was a great game. Thank you all for watching. We had a lot of fun today. We hope you did too, and we hope to see you here next time on Contraption. Bye-bye. I just learned that the correct final score is 19 to 15, and the red team is still the winner.
The Disney Channel. Share the magic. Here's what's coming up next.